Morning, the official section film, all apologies. We have the press conference now. Good morning, as I was saying, this is the press conference corresponding to the official section film, all apologies. We have with us the director, Emily Tang, the actor, Chen Taishen, the producers, Yang Jian and Chow Keung, and we've also got the translation, consecutive translation from Chinese into Spanish, Yong Jin, and they are prepared to answer your questions. There's one in the back there. Let's listen to it. Hi, good morning. I would like to ask the director, how much reality and how much of fiction is there in the story narrated in your script? And to the cast, I would like to ask, or the actor, I would like to know what opinion you have as regards to the problem that the film addresses.
可能我以前拍的题材都比这个更敏感，所以当那个我们的那个出品人给我让我来拍这个电影的时候，我自己没有感觉到它好像很敏感，我觉得还好吧，因为它是更多的是探讨人性的电影，探讨这个生命无常的电影，所以我觉得还好，并不是包括在中国内地，就是中国内部来讲也没有觉得这是一个特别敏感的题材。
I've made some previous films which have dealt with issues that are much more sensitive. I think that this is it's not such a sensitive subject. When we had a script, when we wrote the script for to address this issue in China, the truth is in the interior of China, inland China. For us, it's not it's not such a difficult issue, because what I wanted to do is to show the life of people, of the people there, and how people think about the things that happened in throughout the script. Yes, there was also a question to the actors, how the actors see, what do the actors have as regards this issue? For me, it's a subject which is very powerful, and it's very special because we're talking about love, we're talking about feelings of the life we live in.
我扮演的这个角色和整个影片当中的两个家庭人物之间的这种关系呢，由于一个偶然的事件，把这个生命啊推向了一个 无法选择的一个境况，在这种境遇当中，整个影片我作为演员感受到，导演的视角，让我们就是看到了每个人心灵深处非常细腻的那个敏感的心灵的那种神经啊，让你去考量自己的，那个感受到那些挣扎。 那你怎么去做出一种抉择？那我扮演的这个角色呢，就是他做出了一个极致的抉择，但是原因是出于爱，出于中国传统的一种伦理，叫无孝为大，无孝有三，无后为大，不孝有三，无后为大的这样一个。
I am the protagonist of this film, and this character, because of an accident that has happened, it has changed the life of two families. And being an actor, I now have to find
uh,
I've got to find the way I feel through the help of the director to. It was very difficult for me to find the right fine line that exists vis-a-vis portraying the actor because the character because it. That is to say, I have chosen a very extreme way of portraying the role, but the origin of the decision I made is the love of life. Sí. So you can't hear it without a microphone. Can you repeat that? Sorry. In the final reflection of what the actor says, it seems to me more a love upon a story about unhappiness. What do you think as regards to this? I think it's a story about unhappiness.
就我感觉这个电影，这导演他是一个开放的结局，好像我们的人生永远没有一个完整的答案。他的情感，他在他做出一个选择的时候，其实也掉入了另外一个陷阱。 所以这个电影很细腻的把我们人，就是说每个人欲望和那个爱的那个挣扎当中啊，走向一个很变化的那样一个无常的一个。就是我其实也想说这个，因为我们其实因为想这个电影可以发行吧，所以。 Normally， 通常来讲就是一个电影差不多两个小时之内，然后实际上对我来讲，这个故事只是因为我想把它拍成一个太漫长的那么一个故事，所以才把一个选择点选择在那个地方。实际上，这个故事的结尾可以再往很后推移，然后它还继续会发生很多的故事，因为我们刚才就是那个演员也说了，就是我们这个故事是通过一个家庭的意外。 一个生命的意外，然后导致了两个家庭走上他们不归路。其实就是说，故事可以一直推移到，比如说像他被判了刑，后来，然后他出来以后，他会不会他去寻找他的儿子？然后那个怀孕的女人妈妈，她将来怎么办？就这个命运是一直可以，如果有人愿意的话，我觉得可以一直拍下去。就是可以，这是一个我觉得是一个真的是一个非常开放，然后永远会变化的结局的一个故事。
The truth is, I consider that at the end it's not unhappiness. The ending is left completely open. That is to say, many things can happen. After everything that happens, one goes to jail, the mother takes the son, but what happens if the man who leaves jail hasn't gone to pick up? What's going to happen after? That is to say, after he gets out of jail, the ending is very open. We don't really know the life that we live in every day. We don't know exactly what's going to happen at the end of the day. And the director wanted to also say that obviously she has made this film. She had to control the rhythm of the film, that is to say, and she decided upon at the end of the film, the ending, she decided upon that ending, but whoever wants to keep going with the film, for example, can, the story can keep going because we don't know where it finishes, so therefore the ending is very open, so therefore anything can happen in life, that's what I'm trying to say with the ending.
就是导演处理这个结局让我们感觉到就是 非常开放的感受到了我们人生那种对希望，但是在希望背后到处是充满了一种无奈和一种不可预测的一个未来。这是这个电影，我感觉到非常结尾非常了不起的地方。And
especially when we, at the ending of the film, the director has decided to finish it this way because, like we said before, there are so many. There are so many feelings and so many issues that we really don't know where we are. We've always got the hope that things are going to go well, but sometimes we also feel a bit impotent to the fact that we can't about how things and the events that take place in our life. Hi, good morning. I would like to ask the director how much you're denouncing really, and it's almost you're dancing. And what's the issue? Of feminist movements or the role and claiming the role played by women. I did not whether there's a critic, is it a critique in the film, or is it something that just happens? And also the issue of feminism, the feminism movement in China.
这个专门这个关于这个就是好像介父生态呀，这方面比较敏感的这个介父生子确实是，我觉得在伦理上是一个，不光是在中国吧，我觉得在全世界就是在人类社会它都是一个就是说一种就是一个伦理的问题，一个非常敏感的话题，然后是不能说敏感，是充满争议性的，充满争议性的话题。然后我觉得就是说我们这个故事，其实我非常喜欢这个点，因为这个点就是说作为女导演哈，我不知道是不是因为我作为女导演，当时就是说我们这个故事那个我们的编剧把这个剧本就是给我的时候，一开始其实还有很多不成熟的地方，但是我就非常喜欢这个核心的这个部分，可能是我自己身为女性，然后我也有生育，然后我觉得这个在这个过程中，就是它特别能反映，就这个介父生子能反映，就是人性非常内心深处，就是非常冲突的东西。比如说对于我们的女主角那个角色，就她的救赎，然后她的内疚，她的痛苦，而且这种救赎，她的痛苦是立体的，她对自己的家庭，然后对别人的家庭，这种争议性是，就它带来这种魅力吧，可能觉得是我一个创作的动力。然后其实在中国，我觉得就是说我也没有办法去考察，就是到底比如说在民间有多少这样的事情发生，但是我想说一点，就是可能中国人就是一个非常就是注重这个孩子的民族，就尤其是男孩子，就是确实是这个是几千年的传统，就是像电影里面所反映的，就是像泰森演的这种角色那样的一个就是相对比较底层的这样的这种人，在中国甚至包括今天，好像中国的经济已经发展比以前有了飞速的发展，高度的发展，但其实很多人就这样在外面奔波，然后唯一的希望就是他们的下一代，所以当他的下一代没有的时候，这种打击非常的巨大，然后基本上就是这个传后，然后为了孩子生活的好，这样的一个就是中国人的这种思维习惯吧，还有这种社会传统，就是能够就是发生的这种，就是像这种介父生子啊，就是还是有，但我不能去考证，就是到底有多少事情在，到底有多少有多少就是说就是真实的个案就是发生，但确实是有。
Bueno,
if we're talking about ethic, this is very disputable if we're talking about ethics, but the director, the director liked the script very much because she's also been a mother, and especially she has participated in how the script was written, so therefore she's got the feelings, she knows the feelings of being a mother, so therefore especially in China, this is very important in China, especially to have a son, and this is very, in the feeling of a lot of Chinese, it's especially important to have a son, and the actor, the protagonist, albeit he's working in the city, and he's got a better standard of living, economically he's much better, but the most important thing for him is to have a son, and that is to say, and that's the most important thing, and that's why the issue of having a son, no matter what, so therefore in the Chinese society, what's happening, this is happening, but she doesn't know how much, or what she can really criticize vis-a-vis this subject, but it's very important because it's something which is quite special and delicate for the Chinese.
关于那个中国妇女啊，妇女在中国的地位现在怎么样？
我觉得要看那个社会阶层和地区，就是在经济比较发达的地区，我。比如像我自己，我感受不到什么那个，就是女性过于受压制。但是我觉得就是可能在一些因为中国经济的发展特别不平衡，然后比如说像内陆的地区，西北， 西南什么比较偏远的少数民族地区，可能我觉得那个地女妇女的位置，社会地位，然后经济状况还是跟男性社会有很大的这个差距，所以我觉得这个是 it depends on the area.
When we're talking about feminism, it depends upon what area or what region, and it depends upon what class you belong to. That is to say, in the cities, women work and almost have half the power, but she's never had any difficulty in the sense that she's being a woman director, but out in the country, for example, in the hinterland of China, the women do have much less power, so therefore they encounter many more difficulties.
Sí, hola.
Yes, hi. Good morning. I would like to ask whether the protagonist, if she had rejected the pregnancy instead of going ahead with it, if she'd have aborted, do you think there would have been a dilemma? Or what about a similar or a different film? Because that would have brought about a certain dilemma as well.
Yes, 就当我们不谈他个人的家庭的时候，我其实很 respect 他这样的选择，就是我觉得只可能就是说只有女性啊，我不知道这是不是我的偏见，我觉得只有女性会在那一时刻，就是当那个强奸发生的那一刻，就当他的语言说你知道我们什么都没了，他不能再生，就可能就那一句话，就那么一句话，对于他来讲，那种对一个那个他自己有孩子女性那种力量，可能就一下击碎了他所有的防线，然后我很爱这一时刻，就这个戏剧矛盾巨大转变的时刻，然后当然当他第二天清醒起来，他要回到他的现实生活中，然后他要想到他自己的家庭，自己的丈夫，自己的孩子将来怎么办，但是所以我觉得那一刻的犹豫和接受实际上就是说，反正我觉得作为一个女性导演，我非常就是爱这样的戏剧时刻。
Obviously, if the woman takes another decision, this film wouldn't be this film, it'd be another kind of film. But what I especially like, as being a woman director, I like the sensitive side when the the scene when she rapes her, she said, you know, we have nothing left because we've lost a son. And what the woman feels at that moment is she feels blame, she feels guilty towards the son of the man who had died in the accident. That moment when she changes, and well, obviously she feels guilty at that moment, but obviously the next day she goes back to normal day-to-day living and she goes back to her day-to-day. She'll have to confront to real life, so therefore she likes that sensitivity of the change, the choice that she makes at that moment. Hi, good morning. I'd like to know, as we've seen the film and how resignedly each of the characters, especially the women, take accept what happens, it seems that there shouldn't be any reprisal later with the rapist, but you wanted to add, as if it was a fact in real life, that this man is then condemned for 6 years in jail. It doesn't seem that this society that the film reflects can then take those measures, or that there is, I don't know. You understand what I'm saying? I don't know exactly what you're trying to say. Watching the film, it doesn't seem that later the protagonist, the woman protagonist, reports the man who raped her, and then he goes to jail, and then he ended up in jail. Why did you add that at the end of the film?
Why 的结局、
这个是其实后面的情节里面是暗示了这样的可能性，就是说因为那个女孩子她的丈夫知道这件事情的时候，她跟她的这个女主角见面的时候，女主角问她就是你怎么知道这件事情，然后这个她的丈夫回答是你的孩子的父亲的老婆，其实就是指他的老婆告诉他的，那就是说他的老婆回去把这件事情揭出来，那么就是说在法律上，这是一个就是说在中国的法律上，这种行为，那个就是说是会，就是因为他有一种言语的威胁，就是他这个强奸，虽然就是我们看到那个女孩子她最后答应了，就是这个就是我替你生，但就是说他在那个他们两个人就是这个有性关系的那一刻，就是他有一种言语的威胁，那么就说在法律上是有可能会是被判刑的。
As we've seen, the woman asked her husband how he knew that she was pregnant of her neighbor, and she said because his wife talked about this, and the truth is that exists in society, that, and even though the woman accepts that she wants to get pregnant to have the son, it is a rape case because there's a threat there, and at the end he has to go to jail, so therefore, and that's where that finishes really. Hi. From the point of view of a Western woman, we don't understand the position of the both protagonists, quote unquote. They're not to blame for anything that happens, but nevertheless, they undertake all of the decisions that the husbands make. So therefore, how is that explained? That is to say, is that due to poverty, or do all Chinese women, would all Chinese women behave that way? That's what I'm trying to say.
他的这个决定是因为两个男人做出来的，对吧？他是因为他很穷，他处于一个比较低下的地位呢，还是他处于什么样的原因，就说是来做出这个决定的？
我觉得这个就是有两个原因。第一个原因我已经提到了，就是说他出于对那个孩子的一种救赎，就是说这种他因为是他觉得是他自己的丈夫，然后开车出了这个交通事故。然后不管具体在那个过程中那个车是怎么翻的，但是她觉得是由她的丈夫来开的这个车，所以她那种内疚，我觉得就刚才我提到，就是说作为一个就中国女性，就是她的那种内疚感对这件事情会非常强烈，因为她觉得这跟她的丈夫有关，是因为她的家庭导致了对方唯一的孩子没有了，而且何况就在他们强奸发生那一刹那，他还知道就是说那他的老婆不能再生育，就是他们永远就没有这个孩子。这个又要刚才牵扯到我刚才不知道谁说的那个问题，就是这个孩子在中国社会来讲，就是中国人，就这个刚才的演员也提到，就是说不孝，我们叫不，有一句古话啊，几千年的古话叫不孝有三，无后为大。我不知道这个怎么翻，但就是说就是没有孩子，这个是 Oh my God， 这已经就是你的生命，就是说一切都没有意义。然后就所以就是这一点，这刚才这第一点，就是说这个女孩子她这种对那个家庭那种歉意，就是我们英文名字 Oh apologies， 那个歉意是非常大。然后你看我们那个监制，就是我们别的可能中国人觉得很能够理解哈。然后第二个就是说，就是她自己确实她的那个丈夫也确实是就是急需要钱，腿都快断了。然后在电影里面，其实我也拍了，就是也呈现了这一点，就是我觉得中国社会现在确实面临着一些问题，就是在这个就是社会发展过程中，一切都很商业，医院也很商业，就是说你没有钱拿过来的时候，那我就先不给你做手术，放在那。你看她的那个丈夫就被扔在那个医院的走廊里面，那对她一个就开着那么一个小店的一个年轻的一个妈妈，然后她非常，她也爱她的丈夫啊，就是我这个爱有多少我不管，但 anyway 这个人是她的丈夫，然后她有责任，她觉得自己有责任去救她的丈夫。那我觉得她在可能在那个强奸发生的一刹那里面，就这刚才我说这个两层意思，就是在一瞬间替她做了，对，替她人性的善良，替她做了这个决定，然后她自己也要承受，她的家庭也要承受，所有人都要承受。
There are two points there especially. The first thing is what you mentioned before. The first point would be what the woman feels of guiltiness to because of the son that died, but she's got nothing to do with it, but her husband did it. So therefore, if her husband did it, in a Chinese family and a Chinese woman, obviously, as your husband did this, your husband forms part of you. So therefore, she feels to blame for the boy that dies. And because of the love of this boy, that's why she makes the decision she makes. Because to have a son in China is, as I said before, very important. There are many, many old proverbs or sayings that said, if you don't have a son, it's as if you've lost your roots. And that is very important for the Chinese people. That's the first thing I wanted to say. And secondly, obviously, the second point is that the poverty issue that you mentioned, because the husband is in hospital, he can't pay for his operation. They've taken him out of the hospital room and put him out in the corridor, and therefore the woman, in one way or another, his wife, has to find the money, and she manages to find the money. She loves her husband very much, and that love, it may be more or less, but that's her husband, and she's got to try to save her husband. And that's the second point that I wanted to issue. That's why, according to these two points, I've said that's the decision that helps her to make the decision that she makes at the end of the day. I'm not too sure whether I've not understood you correctly, but perhaps you've got to answer the fact whether is that a normal reaction, or as her as a woman in China, that say we Western women to take on the guiltiness or whatever, or the actions of your husband, is that normal because in China? Because it's very difficult for us to understand being a woman from the Western world.
比如说如果这个事情发生在我身上，我应该不会这样选择就是说因为我有文化，我有别的能力，你知道吗？就是说我会去比如说找律师，或者 anyway 反正我有一些别的方法，因为我受过教育，我有更多的社会的资源，我有朋友来帮我。但是我觉得在生活在那种村子里面，那样一个可能只受过初中的教育啊，就是那个初三那样的教育，然后他又没有什么社会资源，然后你这么大的一个事情发生在他面前的时候，我觉得像那样层次的女性，中国女性，应该是他们一种本能的选择。对，
我认为这不是中国女人的问题。
嗯，
我认为这个问题不是中国女人的问题。
嗯，
也跟电影没有关系。
The director says that especially it depends upon the class you're in. For example, if this happened with her, she would obviously not take this decision because she's educated, and she's talking about the director, and she would find other solutions. And she can find other solutions, she can find lawyers or other means in order to resolve this problem. But obviously, the protagonist, the woman in the film, she's a young woman, perhaps she's not gone to school too much, she lives in a small country town, she hasn't got the means really to go to, or anywhere to go, and therefore in that case she only has that decision to make really at the end of the day. And what was just added by this gentleman on my left is that especially it's not a problem of Chinese women only.
东方啊，在东方民间的这种老百姓传统五千年的这样个道德伦理当中啊，都有一种良心的一种歉意和一种赎罪的这样一个每一个女性包括男性对于就是一个家庭失去孩子，就是说没有这个下一代，那么在群体意识里头都有都看得很重。如果说伤掉把对方的家庭失去一个孩子的时候呢，全部都有很深很深的歉意，就像我们这个电影一样，是全部是歉意啊。这也是中国传统文化当中一个良知的一个考量吧，这是很深刻的一点。
我的 Kiran
The actor would like to add, if we're talking in general about Eastern or Oriental women, well, the culture that we've been brought up with and the way we've been taught to think, to lose a son is very important for a family. It's like, and as you can see in the film, the entire family, not only the man that caused the accident, but the entire family has felt guilty towards the other family, and this is something which is very important for us. In the film, there's a scene which there's a shot, it's practically the same twice. It's shown twice when you see that there's this man fishing and you see a cow in the background in that landscape. It's practically the same shot twice. Does that have any special meaning, or whether you did that on purpose? The man fishing on the river, I think she's referring to. That's the most beautiful river in that landscape, in that area, in that region. And what he means is he's sitting there on his own, he's very alone, and he misses his son. On the one hand, I think he was on his own fishing, and the other one, and he talks to his son in his wallet with the photo. What I wanted to show there, really, with that scene, is that he was very alone, or felt very alone.
当自己有了孩子以后啊，他的好像人生的这个意义，他就有了光芒啊，他就所以当他有了孩子以后，他在那儿钓鱼的时候是充满了好像生命有了意义了，感觉到又重新开始了，所以对他以前的孩子也有一种连接啊，所以他在那儿钓鱼的时候，应该是他的心灵从那个痛苦的那个失去儿子以后的痛苦当中找到了一个新的希望。
For Chinese men, as there's a lot of pressure, the only hope, their hope is to have a son, as I was saying again. And sitting down at the riverside fishing, and he knows that he's going to have another son, and this makes him feel hopeful once again, because he's lost one son, but he still has a hope of life again, and that's also very important. Just a question. The hospital issue, is that fiction or reality? That is to say, if you don't pay for the operation, you get thrown out of the hospital. Is that more fiction, or is that what's happened in Chinese hospitals nowadays?
Yes, this is true. It is true.
Actually, China, so-called a socialist country, but they are really privatized. You need money to solve your own problem. We don't have a security.
Bueno, es verdad. En China,
there are social classes for the rich people, for the officers, not for the ordinary, and especially for the people who live in the marginal society.
Bueno, es verdad, no es afición en este momento en la sociedad.
That's true. She's just repeating what she's saying. In Chinese society, we've got a lot of problems. Those that are a higher class and they've got a lot of money, they've got a lot more social security. And those that don't have a lot of power, well, the truth is they don't have so much.
Preguntas, por favor.
Further questions, please. Someone over here in the second row. This is the last question, by the way. Hi, good morning. More than the commitment that women may have, the rejection of the husband of the woman that gets pregnant, it seems that he can have a son with the other husband, but it's provoked her, but then he rejects her. And on the other hand, that makes me think of the lack of communication which exists. It seems that there's no communication between them, and I'm under the feeling that the women don't have enough communication, or don't communicate enough with their husbands.
这个丈夫好像后来他不接受这个现实，他不接受这个现实。然后这样就是说，他觉得他感觉到电影里头这两个夫妇没有交流，他们之间没有交流。
我觉得这是很多那个就是家庭的问题吧，就是男性和女性就是那个交流比较少，或者在某些问题上无法沟通。其实我们刚才一直在谈那个女性的视角，所以她刚才我很喜欢这个问题，就是她刚才的那个问题正好是作为我们那个女主角丈夫，她代表一种男性的视角，就是说作为一个男性的视角，她可能更看重就是说我的妻子是我的。
嗯哼。
然后你为什么要去听另外一个人生孩子，然后我不能接受你的身体去怀着别的男人的孩子。然后在那一刻我就觉得这个男性就觉得，就是他当然也对他的家庭有歉意，但是在他就说这个歉意跟他我的女人，你是我的女人，就这样的这种就是这个平衡里面，然后他那种男权的那种，就是我的女人怎么能给别的男人生孩子，已经完全占据了上风。所以我觉得那个她的丈夫正好代替的是另外一个男性的视角。
First of all, I like the question you asked me very much, because we are talking about the point of view, a lot about the point of view of women, but the question is related to the point of view of a man. Even though this man feels he's guilty because he caused the accident, but to a certain extent, my wife is mine, and that's what I'm trying to say. And albeit I feel guilty, but how can she have the son of another man? Albeit I do feel guilty. But the limit is, well, I'm a man, nevertheless, and the idea my wife is mine, her body is mine, and that's all mine. And that's the masculine or the man's point of view. Yes, the...
并不很想这样做，但是他看不见他不开心这样做，他只是想他自己，我要一个男孩，因为他们只有一个女儿。对。
In many families have these kinds of problems, these communication problems, and they can't communicate vis-a-vis any given specific subject. Well, at the beginning of the film, he wanted the woman to take medicine so that she can have a son, and at that time that there seemed to be much more communication between them, but at least in this film between them, no, there has not been that much communication. No, not at all. Okay, thank you very much to everyone. Shei Shei.
Thank you.
Thank you.